Today on 52 FAQ, Bayer insecticide as a coral dip. Hi, I'm RT, your host of BRStv's 52 FAQ, where we answer all kinds of reefing questions from our popular series, 52 Weeks of Reefing. Today we're answering Francisco Martinez's question, what percentage of Bayer to water do you use? I've heard a lot of different answers, but I'd like to hear your thoughts. While coral dips work well and are really easy to use, we found that in addition to using these dips, Bayer Complete Insect Killer is a really powerful option to help prevent coral pests. A lot of hobbyists seem to be experimenting with this method. We borrowed our recipe from Mike Paletta. With Mike Paletta's recipe, the dose is a little on the high side, with his article listing 400 milliliters per 2.5 gallons of water. To simplify that a bit, our math works it out to 160 milliliters of Bayer per gallon of water. Since we're dipping corals in larger batches, we like to use a heater to keep the water the ideal temperature and power heads to provide flow to knock stunned pests and critters off the coral. We also use a turkey baster to blow water over the surface of the coral in a more targeted manner to help dislodge any pests. After about 15 minutes, you can remove the coral from the dip solution, giving corals like Acropora and Zoanthids a good shake or two to dislodge any stubborn pests. I'd avoid doing this with LPS, however, since it could be stressful on the coral's fleshy polyps. Instead, use a toothbrush or other small brush to gently clean off the coral's skeleton. It's imperative that you dip the coral in a bucket of heated tank or salt water to rinse the solution off the coral prior to it entering the tank. In our dip regimen, we use two rinse buckets to make absolutely sure the coral is Bayer-free. A few things to consider is that while this Bayer dipping method has so far shown some impressive results from quite a few reefers, for us it's simply a step in a multi-step process to help us prevent pests in our reef tanks. In addition to Bayer, we use Coral RX, intense visual inspection, and a lengthy quarantine period where potential issues will arise in a controlled environment away from our display tank and our coral collection. Finally, one of the most important steps in the entire dip process is using adequate protective gear. All coral dips, not just Bayer, are designed to kill pests, so using gloves and tweezers to prevent contact with the dip, goggles to prevent any splashes from getting into your eyes, and having towels handy to clean up any spills will go a long ways towards keeping you, the aquarist, happy and healthy. If you're interested in learning more about coral dipping, quarantine, or coral pests in the reef aquarium, do yourself a favor and check out week 49 of 52 Weeks of Reefing, How to Prevent and Treat Reef Tank Pests. Don't forget, answering your questions is what the 52 FAQ is all about, so ask us something you want to know in the comments area below. See you soon with the next 52 FAQ.